click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to solve a problem based on Wugel's approximation method. We'll go extremely slow. This is a first problem based on VAM method. This is a highly scientific method of solving a problem based on cost minimization. Let's read the problem first. So in the problem, company has three factories at locations A, B and C, and they have three warehouses D, E and F, and monthly capacities are 11, 13 and 19, whereas the demands are 6, 10, 12 and 15. And we are also given the shipping cost per unit, and we are supposed to find out the initial feasible solution by Wugel's approximation method. Let's first draw the diagram and try to work out the solution. So here we'll just note down the problem first. Here are my factories A, B and C. And here are my warehouses W1, W2, W3 and W4. I'll just note down the cost on the top left side of each cell. And if you look at the problem carefully, we are given the capacities of the factories as 11, 13 and 19, which I'll write against A, B and C, 11, 13 and 19. This is my supply, also called as the capacity. And we have the demands of 6, 10, 12 and 15 at the different warehouses. So here is my demand. 6, 10, 12 and 15. Let's check first of all whether the problem is balanced or not. So let's do the totaling from both the sides. It comes to 43. This way is also 43. So the problem is balanced. Now we need to solve this problem by using Wugel's approximation method. Under this method, we will make two additional columns called as row penalty and column penalty. They can be also called as row differences and column differences. Under this, we are going to calculate certain penalties. Now let's try to understand what is the penalty. In the first row, if you look at the cell and their cost, which is the lowest possible cost? 26. Which is the next possible lowest cost after 26? 32. The difference between 26 and 32, that is 6, is called as the penalty of that cell. In the same manner, if you look at the second row, my lowest cost is 28. And my next lowest cost is 34, jinka difference hai, again is 6. In my third row, my lowest cost is 36, and my next lowest cost is 54. The difference between the two will be 18. What we did row wise, we are going to do the same thing column wise. Jo chiz humne pehle row wise kiya tha, वही चीज अभी हम कॉलम वाइज करेंगे. तो फर्स्ट कॉलम में सबसे लोवेस्ट नंबर है 34, नेक्स्ट लोवेस्ट इज 42, इनका डिफरेंस है 8. सेकेंड कॉलम में सबसे लोवेस्ट नंबर है 32, नेक्स्ट लोवेस्ट है 36, इनका डिफरेंस है 6. इनका डिफरेंस है 4. थर्ड कॉलम लोवेस्ट कॉस्ट इज 28, नेक्स्ट लोएस्ट इज 36, difference is 8. And last column, lowest cost is 26. Next lowest is 46. Difference is 20. Now select the highest penalty among the row and the column penalties. We will see that the highest penalty comes under 20. How much is the lowest cost in this particular column? So I have got 26 as the lowest cost, where my supply is 11 and my demand is 15. आपको highest penalty जहाँ पर आता है वो वाला cell लेना है, वो वाला row या column लेना है, और उस row या column के सबसे कम cost कहाँ पर है? 26. यहाँ पर आपका penalty कितना है? So यहाँ पे आपका supply कितना है? 11. और यहाँ पे आपका demand कितना है? 15. So 11 और 15, whichever is less, it will be 11. 11 minus 11, I'll write 0 here. 20 minus 11, 15 minus 11, it will be 4. Now, since we got a 0 in the first row, we'll cancel the first row. Because we have cancelled the row, my row penalties will remain same, 6 and 18. And I will work out the column penalties again. My column penalty will be 34 and 64, difference is 30. 36 and 54, difference is 28. 36 and 28, difference is 8. 46 and 82, the difference will be 36. So now, since we have cancelled the first row, our row penalties remain same, and we recalculated the column penalties. आपको column penalties हर step में फिर से निकालना पड़ेगा अगर आपका row cancel हो गया तो. अगर row cancel हुआ तो row penalties same रखिए, column penalties फिर से निकालो. अगर column cancel होता है तो column penalties को same लिखो और row penalties फिर से calculate करो. Now we are again going to follow the same method or the same technique, which is the highest penalty. 6, 18, 36, 8, 28, 30. मेरा highest penalty है 36. यहाँ पे सबसे कम cost कहाँ पर है इस particular column में? 46. Supply is 13, demand is 4. दोनों में से whichever is less में यहाँ पर आएगा 4. 4 minus 4 is 0. 13 minus 4 is... अब मेरा इस कॉलम के इसमें जीरो आ गया डिमांड में, तो आई विल सिंपली कैंसिल दिस कॉलम. बिकॉज आई हैव कैंसिल द कॉलम, माय कॉलम पेनल्टीज विल रिमेन सेम. नाउ आई विल चेंज माय रो पेनल्टीज बाय डूइंग द रीकैलकुलेशन. इन द सेकंड रो वी हैव 28 एंड 30, 28 एंड 34, द डिफरेंस शैल बी 6. In the third row, it is 36 and 54. The difference shall be 18. Now, the highest penalty in the third cycle is 6, 18, 30, 28, 8. सबसे ज़्यादा penalty आपका 6 है. इस column में सबसे कम cost कहाँ पर है? 34. जहाँ पे आपका supply 9, demand 6, which less में 6 आएगा? 9 minus 6, it shall be 3. 6 minus 6, it shall be... So, we have got a 0 here. So, I have to cancel this first column. Now, again, because I have cancelled the column, my column penalties will remain same. And my row penalties may or may not change. 36 and 28. 36 and 54. My highest penalty at this stage is 28, where the lowest cost is 36, supply 3, demand 10. You supply 3, 3 minus 3, 0, and 10 minus 3, 7. Since I got a 0 here, I have to cancel this second row. Now we are left with only two columns and one row. Because we are left with only one row, now there cannot be any more column penalties calculated. We'll simply do the allocation directly. This 7 demand will be satisfied from this supply of 19. So 7 minus 7 0 or 19 minus 7 12. और यहाँ पर आपका 0 हो गया तो ये हो जाएगा cancel. अब बचा यहाँ पे 12 और यहाँ पे 12, वो पूरा का पूरा यहाँ पे हम transfer कर देंगे. 12 minus 12 is 0, 12 minus 12 is 0. Since this is 0, we'll cancel this. Since this is 0, we'll cancel this. Okay, this is what we have got, a solution based on Vogel's approximation method. Now what's my solution? My solution is, from A I will supply to W4 11 units at 26 rupees per unit. So A to W4 11 units multiplied by 26. Again I will supply from B to W1 6 units. Multiplied by 34. B to W to 3 units. Multiplied by 36. B to W 4 units. Multiplied by 46. C to W 2 7 units. Multiplied by 54. C2 W3 12 units. Multiplied by 36. So we are done with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We are done with the all the transportation allocation. We simply multiply this now. 11 into 26, it will be 286. 6 into 34, it will be 320. 3 into 36, it is 108. 4 into 46, it will be 184. 7 into 54 is 378. And 12 into 36, it will be 432. At the end, I will simply add this 6, 14, 22, 30, 32, 3 carry, 11, 12, 13, 20, 28, plus 3, 31, 3 carry, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10, 13, plus 4, 1, 7, 1, 2 is my total of the solution, or the total shipping cost or the transportation cost. Okay, so this is the Vogel's approximation method. This method is the most scientific method. Please remember, whenever in the problem no method has been specified, you have to always solve the problem by this method. Thanks for watching the video. Do subscribe to our channel eKida by pressing the bell icon.